Store information on this screen is just
Thank you. alright, I'll be alright. Yeah. Not too bad. If you wanted to do Adam Arcata after our one win at Highfield yesterday, no, there is.
I'm looking for a Cole Cummins.
Well, there's a breaking play, we've got Cole Cummins.
See, I'm pretty sure this doesn't happen to your Aggers and your Dan Norcrosses, but I've just realised I've had the microphone plugged into the headphone socket. So that's kind of on me. Apologies for the quietness of the commentary thus far. Let's assume you haven't heard anything. Neston are bowling at Newton-le-Willows in the second semi-final of the Echo Cup. Winners play Birkenhead Park in the final. Nathan Hughes is swinging from the hip a little bit. He's hit two sixes now, including that one, just straight down the ground. And at the end of the sixth over, Newton are 37 for one. That six off Chris Dixon was the only scoring shot of the over. Been slightly beset by technical problems, but putting the microphone in the headphone socket, that was really my fault. Sorry, I'm a cricket writer, I'm not a microphone user. You may also be able to tell I'm short of a co-commentator at the moment, so anybody in the Birkenhead area who fancies chatting about cricket, come along. I'm in the blue tent. Luke Jones starts his fourth over. Matt de Brabander, that's a lovely little late cut there down to the third boundary, and that's going to be a four. Nice start. Been a bit of an up and down start from Newton here, having won the toss and chosen to bat. They've lost their excellent young opener Ben Walkden, who was stumped off Luke Jones earlier. Into the final, out of the power play now. They're just trying to keep the momentum going with the field spread of it. Jones now, Hughes is forward and pushing into the covers. There's no run. That's a bit of an expansive shot there. A big shot, but just for one run. As there's a fielder perfectly positioned on the cow corner boundary for that kind of shot. Called a wide lead down the leg side. I don't know why a wide just got a musical sting from the PA man, but he's a low unto himself. Bit quicker and flatter than Jones that, and pushed out to the point boundary. They think about a second, and then Hughes is sent back in a bit of a hurry. clubbed out into the offside, and that's going to beat the fielders. And that is another four for Nathan Hughes. So a good start by him. ...49-1 from seven overs, Newton-le-Willows. They'll be looking to set... I think they'll be looking to set a bit more than Birkenhead Park did. Birkenhead Park set 154 and managed to defend it in the end, but it took some... It took a real squeeze in the second half of that Upton innings, and I think they would have wanted a bit more of a cushion. And I think Newton, having seen how that game has gone, won the toss and chose to bat, meaning they're confident of setting a target themselves. I think they'll be aiming for 160, 170... as Chris Dixon continues his spell with his second over. As Diplobander smears this one down to the third boundary for a single, I'm delighted to be joined by Upton club captain Matt Owen. How are you, Matt?
Yeah, good, thank you. A little bit disappointed, naturally.
Yeah.
Off the back of a defeat, but... You know, still the day's all going as well as it can do at the minute. Things running smoothly, weather staying away, so happy enough, I suppose.
I thought you stayed in that game quite deep, didn't you? Sort of until the last five or six overs.
Yeah, I think probably two or three overs before that is when it started to slip away from us a little bit. We just got caught up and had a couple of overs where we only sort of scored three or four, and then we lost a couple of quick wickets. And I think Dan Seaton being dismissed on 50 odd was probably the moment at which we were behind the eight ball, really. I mean, I'm not a T20 specialist myself at number mm-hmm. six necessarily, so I just run around for people. But he batted well, and we, like you say, we were in it for a good amount of time. Probably halfway through our innings we were favourites, so one of those, isn't it?
Yeah, so it says Dixon balls here to Hughes, and big appeal, not entirely sure what for. Did it hit his pad? They must have been appealing for LBW there, but
yeah,
I'm sure it didn't go
sliding down,
through,
I think.
Yeah,
sliding down.
What do you think is a good total on this deck then?
I think it'll become more difficult as the day goes on, so I'd probably say the scores, I'd say somewhere around what Birkenhead Park got against us will be a decent competitive total, 160 sort of 8 and over range. I'd say would be a good score for Newton here.
That could have been a run out there. Probably should have been. Going to hit three stumps, aren't they?
So yeah, I think probably about 160 is a good total, but Neston have done pretty well so far containing, I would say. Mm-hmm. Relatively slow power play for Newton, but still time to make it up.
Heard
you say De Brabant is still in there, isn't he? So.
Yeah, and Hughes is striking it quite cleanly from the other end as well.
Yeah, so still time.
Mm.
But yeah, I'd say about 160 probably.
Dixon back at his mark now. Right arm round the wicket to Hughes. He's aiming for the commentary tent. Just falls short of the field of it long on. And they run a single. Cross-spotted shot. Is it a bit of a slow pitch? What do you think is the key to bowling on it?
I think that sort of length is probably quite a good length, that hard length, back of the length. I don't think it's a pitch-up wicket necessarily. I think it's slowish. Not as slow as we've had them here sometimes, but it's sticking in a little bit, so I'd say back of the length's a good area to be. Quite difficult to get away from a seam bowling perspective.
Mm-hmm. Dixon's hit that length pretty well in this over, hasn't he?
Definitely, yeah, it's been a good over. You can occasionally get the odd one from that length to stick.
Call the no ball here. Is there a fielder behind, too many fielders behind square? Because it seems to be called from square leg.
Don't know whether it's possibly for having not enough in the ring. Although I thought they did personally.
I can only see, well, there's two out on the boundary, and I just wonder if that square leg is behind the square.
Maybe.
Then that would be the third. Either way, it's a no ball and a free hit for Dibabanda here. In comes Dixon. Dibabanda. Quite often happens with a free hit, that, doesn't it? You almost try too hard to.
I can say that from personal experience, is that every free hit I've ever faced, I think I've faced about six free hits in my life, and I think I've scored four runs in total.
I think it's the same at all levels of cricket, though. The other thing why don't bowlers pretend it's a free hit every time? You just seem to get a better ball when it's a free hit.
Yeah, there's probably some sort of psyche behind it that actually helps. I don't know. No, you're right. It's very rare that you actually see one get hit for six, particularly at this level.
No.
But like you say, even in the professional game, it doesn't seem to happen. So,
change of bowling at the far end because Luke Jones has bowled all of his. Do you know the Neston player as well?
I do. I'm struggling to. Let me just have a look at that. I think this is Chris Finnegan.
Okay. Let's assume it is until we're. So
I'm pretty sure it is in terms of looking at everybody else. Yeah, it is. It's Chris Finnegan.
Chris Finnegan.
Must be, because I know the rest of the names on there. So.
Right. From the far end. Slow bowler, keeper up to the stumps. It's like a little seam up, like bowling cutters,
is.
Isn't it?
It is Chris Finnegan.
Clips into the leg side, that's well struck, and that's gone for four. And it's a blast of jump around for his efforts.
All the proper stuff going on here.
PA man's loving it, isn't he?
Hey, he's having a good day at the moment, he's done okay. If anything, I'd like a little bit more. Some more tunes on.
He did give a musical sting for a wide earlier. Let's see some more of that.
Yeah.
Bit of a delay while they're trying to retrieve the ball from one of the bushes over there and the fence. There's a decent number of spectators, isn't there, I think?
Yeah, well, we normally get quite good crowds down on a Saturday anyway, but this is good. Lots of people coming through.
You're hoping most of the Upton supporters stick around for the rest of the day as well?
I think most of them will. They just love their cricket here, so mm-hmm. I can't see too many disappearing off, even with the looming large of the football.
Yeah. Forgotten all about that.
Yeah, well, yeah.
It's a football free zone, this kind of.
Second sport, isn't it?
Yeah. That's a bit of a full toss there, and managed to get away. We'll have to have a look. The umpire's going to signal that. No, must have just been okay. Looks about waist height.
Another anomaly of cricket, that one. We were talking about that yesterday, about the actual use of the full toss. So it's always a lot harder than you think to get away.
Yeah. Yeah, you do see bowlers in T20s in particular, sort of that sort of shin, knee high full toss where they. But I can't really get a full swing at it.
It's more of a thing now, isn't it?
Yeah.
You're always looking for the ball hitting the deck. I think that's the thing as a batter. Mm. Your eyes are trained for that, and then when you do get that ball, it's actually sometimes.
And it's caught. Caught at sort of a deep gully position. So Hughes's innings, which threatened to get going but never really did, is over. He's gone. Let me just check the score for you now. Thank you.
60 for 2
in the ninth over.
Yes, play cricket's not helping us out here. And I was trying to check if it is actually Finnegan or whether it's Stewart.
It's Mike Stewart, apparently.
It says on there, yeah, but it doesn't look like Mike Stewart, but I could be wrong. Like I say, I know the vast majority of those names, but.
So Hughes' cameo is over. Let's have a look at now.
Quite an interesting little phase of the game now, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely be interesting to see how they go, whether they just happy to see off the middle overs and then go big towards the end, or whether they want to keep going for the boundaries.
Good set.
End of a successful over for, should we say Stuart? I don't know.
Yeah, I'm still on the fence about this, so I need someone to come and help me out. This is where you need like the listener text line or something, don't
Absolutely,
you?
Absolutely, yeah.
That was good over that, coming back after the boundary on the first ball. Doing a pretty good job of keeping it tight, Neston, here, I'd say.
Yeah, is Dixon going to continue now?
Now this is Mike ball. Stewart.
This is Mike
so
Stewart.
It must
from
have been
end.
Finnegan from the other okay. end. Okay. I'm telling you, Mike.
Expert comments are here from people who know 50% of the players' names.
Well, yeah, you know. It's not an exact science yet, is it?
No.
I was right, I should have backed my gut in the first place.
Okay,
say it with enough conviction.
So Mike Stewart is going to be bowling to Safi Abdullah, the Pakistani overseas player for Newton-le-Willows. Left arm spinner is his main trade, but he also doubles as an all-rounder as well, and that's swung away into the leg side, that's going to be four.
Nicely put away.
Yeah, a bit of a loosener from Stewart.
Definitely.
Dragged down a little bit.
Come on, Michael. Good day today, big fella.
There you go. Long on confirmation.
It does help when the field doesn't have some vocal like that. There he is again. Right arm round the wicket. That's a bit of a better length. They go for a quick single and they'll get there quite comfortably.
To the right hander.
Yeah.
Interesting play.
Like it. But putting the fielders back on the leg side,
yeah.
Expecting to go with the spin.
I think it's quite a good way to go. Well, I mean, naturally it's quite a good way to go, but it's quite a good way to go on this pitch as well, because it's a little bit slow, and if you do try and turn it in there for one, found that in the first game when I was facing Mark Rowlands from Birkenhead. It's just, although they're fizzing the darts in a little bit, it's quite hard to actually just roll your wrists on it. It's not necessarily turning a lot. It's just
right. So a lot of them are just going straight.
Yeah,
back to
when you're firing it in and then you're trying to turn on it, and if you go a little bit early, it's quite risky just to get you one really. So that's sort of the interesting element of this pitch at the moment, is that I think it's quite an interesting dynamic between bat and ball at the moment, which is good really, isn't it? It's what you want. I want them all batter friendly.
Definitely, it's interesting watching them work out. I thought your bowlers were they were quite consistent, the Upton bowlers. No one really got. I know Harris obviously, you know, he played a few good shots, he had a lot of sixes, but he never really targeted one particular bowler.
No.
It helped you stay in the game. They were all sort of, the four overs were all sort of 25-30.
Well, yeah, I mean, I'll personally give an assist, I should say, for Al Harris managing to drop him out on the boundary out there, and that.
The tumbling one down there.
Yeah, that was me. Yeah,
so. He didn't have many after that, though, did he?
No, but we've all got personal assists. We dropped him a couple of times, so it is what it is. But he played well, just hit through. But like you say, I think all of our bowlers bowled pretty well. we sort of observed at half time that no one really got picked up or anything, like you say, and it was just interspersed. But Harry spotted well. He just hit through the line, didn't he? And pink ball flies a bit. That's the nature of T20. Comes off for some.
There's a new over for definitely Finnegan.
Definitely Finnegan.
It's driven down the ground by Safi and it goes for four. An interesting one if Newton do get to the final, because Safi was at Birkenhead Park last year.
Oh, okay,
overseas club.
Would make for an interesting matchup.
Yeah, definitely. They sort of followed each other around, those two sides as well. Obviously, both in the Prem last year, both relegated in similar sort of unusual circumstances, and
of course,
both battling it out at the top of Division 1. That's going to be another four clip down the leg side. Leg buys, in fact, signalled. I think it's strange that leg buys don't go against the bowler, because that first ball was better than the second one.
It's really interesting in the sense that we were talking about this as a team yesterday. One of our lads was pitching for leg buys to not be a thing at all.
There's a case for that, yeah. I think if they are a thing, you should put them against the bowler.
I personally agree with that. One of the quirks of cricket, isn't it? More than anything.
Yeah. It's always been like that. Single into the offside for Safi there.
So Newton and Park, the top two in Division 1 at the moment? Springview
are second, although I'm not sure if it's changed yesterday, actually. Okay. Springview got beaten in a very low-scoring game by Newton yesterday.
Okay.
Let me just check the table for you now. But yeah, they're very much...
Normally follow along quite closely.
In fact, Park have gone top.
Oh, okay.
But, well, this doesn't seem to have been updated, actually.
Right.
Because Park's win yesterday has been put on the board, so Newton will have gone top. Newton will still be top and Park second, yeah.
Okay.
Both very much favourites, because obviously without their points deductions last year, they would have been top half or just outside the top half of the Prem. So, you know, it's two quality additions. I sort of feel a bit sorry for the likes of Springview, who are having a really good season, but come up against two sides who haven't really lost many people.
Nice to see a bit of a rejuvenated Liverpool as well.
Liverpool are going well, yeah. I think last season they had a year where they started like a train and then didn't win any, hardly won any games from July onwards.
Right.
Whereas they've kept it up a bit better this year.
That's good.
But I think...
Matty Jackson still captain
though? He is, yeah.
I know Matty quite well. He's a good guy. Wish them well. You want a club like that with... sort of the status the grounds had in of recent times with Lancashire and things.
Yeah.
You want them back in the big time.
That one cut low a bit from Stewart, but Dibabando is equal to it and takes a single.
Sounds like a bit of rain.
A bit more rain falling on the tent, yeah, but spectators don't seem too concerned. No one's running for cover just yet.
Yeah, I don't think it's ever going to rain hard enough to get them off the pitch today.
No, it's not for nothing's forecast anyway.
Just on the air more than anything.
I think the umpires will lean towards keeping them out there, won't they, if they possibly can.
Look, we want to play 120 overs of cricket, don't we? We don't want anything shortened, so...
That's a big shot down the ground. Fielder comes round and gathers. It's just a single.
Luke Camden picking up there, one of the Upton youth system to have moved on to other places. Played a bit of my junior cricket with Luke.
Any others in the team?
I don't think we've got any. Oh no, we have. Si Stokes is in there.
Big shots for four. over mid wicket into the gap from the Rabanda, who's starting to find his range now.
Yeah, so Si Stokes has had a bit to do with the club and things as well. Mm-hmm. So yeah, we've got quite a few in the Chester and Neston ranks over the years. Ultimately, with them being Premier League clubs and us not quite reaching that level ourselves.
Yeah.
Obviously, with where we're at the moment.
But it's a sign for how good the junior section is.
Absolutely, yeah.
We've brought through a lot of good players.
So. Nice to see them back down here, which is good and doing well. Hopefully Luke can get a few afterwards in the reply.
Safi just knocks that down the ground for a single. I think one thing notable about Harris's innings was that all his big shots were straight, weren't they?
Yeah.
He didn't really go across the line.
He's always been a player that can hit the ball hard, and he's mm-hmm. one that, again, he's same age. I think he's same age as me, so played a bit of junior cricket against him mm-hmm. and things, and representative cricket and that sort of stuff. And he's always hit the ball hard and always seemingly looked to target straight. And I think it's a good option today. I mean, we brought the boundary in a little bit just to try and, because you know our lads that have gone well this year have hit well straight as well. Dano and Dan Seaton at the top of the order for us do hit the ball well there, so you know he's cashed in on that, and I think it's a good way to go today. I think it's probably a little bit harder to get the ball out to the corners of the ground, so mm-hmm. therefore going straight through, like we said, with that difficulty with the back of the length kind of things, is that if the ball is full, you might as well just go through and hit through the arc and aim for the screens, really.
So 90 for 2 at the start of the 13th over. That's going to be called wide down the leg side. New bowler as well.
Looks like David Hurst this one.
Again, let's go with that. Let's go with your gut this time.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is.
But here's Hurst. Round the wicket, Safi uses his feet, but can't really get that away. They'll just jog a single. Safi's livid with himself there. He feels like he missed out. Field changes around as the right-handed Deborah Bander comes on strike. He's moved on to 27 from 26 balls. He's one, in fact, who has been a bit more sort of planting the front foot and playing across. He's played a couple of sweeps and a slug sweep for four in the last over. So he's played them well, but with a few are keeping low, aren't they? So it's always a risk.
Yeah, to be honest, it's always a bit of a risk here. I mean, we like to, as a home team, we like to see people sweeping when they play here, because you can get the odd one that rolls a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Not so much over this side of the square, which is why I'm not surprised, but I think to have seen a few shoot like we have,
mm-hmm.
maybe a little bit more surprising over this side. It can sort of over to the right hand side of the square, and we're pretty central today. Over to the right hand side, this does shoot a little bit more.
Something's a bit flatter, a difficult length. Safi tries to give himself room but can't get it away. Oh, he's stumped, runs past it. Excellent bowling. Again, dragging the length back, bringing Safi out of his crease, and looking keeper Matt Strong does the rest, his second stumping after getting Ben walked in earlier. So every time Newton have sort of looked like getting away, putting a partnership together, they've lost a wicket, haven't they?
Yes. Sort of the art of T20 bowling, really, isn't it? Is that mm-hmm. if you can keep breaking partnerships, then teams don't get away. Good time to get that one, I think, just coming towards the crunch time in the innings as such.
Definitely, yeah. You don't have too many new batters starting, trying to start and get up to sort of scoring at 7, 8 and over straight away.
Yeah, always tough. So.
So probably a lot of responsibility on the rubber bander here to stick around and keep the rate up. So that's that chambers. So I see the new batters here. It says Captain Chris Chambers to the crease. Obviously capable of taking some responsibility himself, so we'll see how he goes.
Buzz around for Neston at the moment off the back of that wicket.
Yeah. Nice. I think they'll feel fairly happy with their work so far though.
I think like you said, they've controlled it pretty well.
Yeah, it's 94 for 3 after 13 overs. So from these last 7 overs, I think Newton will be looking, they'll be looking to go about 10s, wouldn't they? I think to get up to 160, 170.
Yeah, I think that's your
big ask.
I think that's your number, I would say. I think 160 is a competitive total. Anything less, you'd probably say you're slightly under par. Or within reason, of course. As I've said before, generally speaking, it will get a little bit slower and lower as the day goes on, so you never know, second half of this game, it
could be a bit trickier.
Yeah, could be.
But they've got some powerful hitters, haven't they, Neston?
Yeah, I mean, that team today is looking strong. Dave Hurst, definitely worth a look at the top of the order. Very good player. Imagine he'll go up the top. Simon Stokes as well, Luke Camden I mentioned before. These guys are all good hitters of the ball.
Mm-hmm.
And they've got a bit of depth going further down as well. I know Matty Strong's had a pretty good year with the bat in the county league as well, made a few scores, so I'd say they've got a good top 5 or 6 there that will be very capable. And see, Ash Davis has been named as captain today. I assume he's doing the T20s. Dane Williams normally does the league stuff.
Yeah, it was so. Dane who I spoke to in the week.
So Dane's a good player as well, so plenty of batting power there.
Feels so powerful that he can't stay on his feet. But
I was just going to say that.
Clearly going down leg. Like, the umpire's not impressed.
Jed Kinsey, one of the county league's best, the umpire. Yeah. Nice to see him here today. Always quite difficult to get an LB out of Jed. Gonna be pretty dead. Which is a batter I quite like.
Yeah.
A good set without a boundary.
Yeah, they need to
find him a little bit, I think.
Keep this up. The racing round quickly, aren't they? Trying to get through these overs.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Sort of settle mentally and like not give them too much time to think.
Well, it'll be interesting to see when Newton do choose to put the foot down.
Yeah,
he's got a couple of overs of Ash Davis left, who, generally speaking, is Neston's sort of go-to bowler, if you like. Has been over a number of years, quite successful in T20. So.
But is it the sort of wicket where you want pace? That's the
well,
thing.
That's the yeah, question. But he was pretty tight early doors, wasn't he?
Yeah, very tight.
I think from what I hear over the years, I mean, again,
Dibba Vander's got hold of that one.
That's gone for 4.
That's gone for 4 through the leg side.
Nice pickup.
Yeah, yeah. Again, just trusting his eye, isn't he? He's
absolutely, yeah.
Swinging across the line.
Yeah, as I was saying on Ash, it was sort of your express bowler as a junior, and I know he played a bit at Chester when they were very successful in T20 cricket.
gone back to his boyhood club at Neston, and I think the sort of suggestion is that he's continued to add to his trade and got a bit more variation and stuff, which might be useful on this deck as well.
Mm-hmm.
So be interesting to see where they go last few overs.
Good comeback from Hurst there after going for the boundary, a couple of dots.
Sort of been the story of the innings really, hasn't it? Is that they pulled it back quite nicely after a boundary's been scored.
That's almost a chance there, because he didn't time that and it nearly went in the air back to the bowler.
Turned into a very good reply, this, isn't it?
Yep.
The pressure on, I'd say.
Sort of see the frustration, Dipper Banda, the way he's sort of walking around, like almost sort of urging himself to make the next one count, isn't he?
I think so. Yeah. I'd feel that he'll be looking for a boundary here again to make it a decent over.
And that's when batters make mistakes and try and hit one they shouldn't.
Yeah.
Clubbed that one as the fielder coming round to it, gets it on the bounce. So after the first ball, four, just one more run off the rest of the over. And that's, like you say, that's been the story of the innings. They've not given away consecutive boundaries, they've not let the batters get on top of them.
Yeah, it's definitely been the thing, so to be applauded for Neston sticking with the slow bowlers at the moment as well.
Yeah, this is going to be the last over for Stewart from this end, and it's 103 for 3 after 15 overs, so 5 overs to go. Dibabanda on strike, likes the look of that one, heaves it out to the long on boundary, it's going to go, it's going to bisect the fielders, it's gone for 4. Now can he back it up with another one? That's the question.
Yeah, straight back to that point again, aren't we? See if they can turn it into a good over, boundary off the first.
They need a couple of big ones to post a good score here, you feel. Only find cover with that one. It's a bit wider from Stewart, possibly deliberately, if he knows he's looking to hit to the leg side all the time. Chambers can't get that one away.
Good dot again.
Mm-hmm.
Again, isn't it?
Yep. I'm very happy with the scoring rate. Into the leg side, but just a single.
So pressure on the boundary again, potentially here off the last.
Yep.
6 off, looking to get 10s.
I think we've mid off up, that's the speed opportunity, haven't we?
Yeah,
they're bowling quite a tight line, but if we can maybe give himself room, maybe try something a bit different. He's been very leg side, which makes it quite easy to set a field to if he's only hitting one.
Yeah, bowl well to a plan at the moment.
Yep.
Nice again there from Stewart, just slightly into the pitch. Comes off slowly, difficult to get away.
So, 4 overs to go. The score is 110 for 3. Dibabanda is on 35 and Chambers is on 3. I think they were even 10 and over from here, we'll just get into 150, which is sort of on that borderline. They'll have to bowl and field really well to defend that, you'd think. And there's Hurst for his third over. Wander's gone for that, got it down the ground, that's going to go. Has that gone all the way? That's gone all the way for six. Again, so boundaries off the first ball of each of the last three overs, but then they haven't backed any of them up.
Well, now's the time, isn't it?
Yep.
Now's the time.
Wander pushes that one to leg, they won't come back for the second.
Excuse me for 1 second, Tom.
Sure, yeah. Chambers goes for a big one there, and it goes all the way. Six over square leg for Chris Chambers. His first boundary, and a good over this for Newton. They needed this. Let's see what Hurst's comeback is. Flatter again and just eased into the leg side for a comfortable single. So big over there for Newton. Three to go there on 124 for three. Hurst finishes with one for 37. I'll tell a lie. He's only bowled three overs, one for 23 so far. Stewart though has bowled out, and it's going to be Ash Davis from this end. From where he was bowling quite nicely earlier, got some good pace on. He went for five runs from his first two overs, so batter's just having a conference about what to expect and how to play him and where to find the gaps.
Tom, that turned into a good over, didn't it?
Yeah, it's the sort of over Newton needed, I was just saying. And Davis coming back on from this end. Let's see if Chambers can keep finding the gaps. Good start for Davis, though.
Yeah, that's the, it's the length we mentioned, isn't it? Slightly back of a length, but doesn't get up as much. I think it's quite difficult for the batters to get away. So,
yeah.
Kind of look like Chambers was a little bit frustrated by that. I can understand that.
Here he is again. Short again. Chambers does get back on this, and then a fairly comfortable single with all the fielders back on the ring. There's going to be singles to anything they get bat on, really, isn't there?
That time in the game where as a fielding team you're happy for a single, really.
Yeah.
Stopping the boundaries if you can.
Oh, cramped him for room a bit there, sort of a bit straighter than he was expecting, normally.
Seems to be the plan again, doesn't it, with mid off and cover in the ring, is that you'd imagine there's not going to be, well, certainly the plan will be not to bowl with any width. It's going to be stump to stump.
Yeah,
hold again, two off four. Mm-hmm. Bit of pressure on again now.
Good drive from Chambers. Is that going to go all the way? That's gone for four. Through the covers. Bit of a release of that pressure. Got one that was just a little bit wider.
Nice shot, that.
Found the gap, yeah. Nice,
well executed. As we said before, perhaps the one downside of pace on the ball. It's off a lot quicker, doesn't it?
Saw a couple of ramps in the first, first game, didn't we? That's a slower ball, nicely pitched up. Hard to get away.
Yes, our number 8, Dave Williams, likes a ramp.
He brings
him out in the league as well. It's very much the modern game, isn't it?
Yeah.
It works for him quite a lot of the time, it's bizarre, really. It's become a scoring shot, hasn't it? I mean,
We
saw a few against us yesterday in the league, and people don't necessarily execute them all the time, but
I mean, if you look at the top class professional game, it's not just a T20 thing anymore. You couldn't find a classically better batter than Joe Root in the world, and yet he plays that shot all the time in test matches. You know,
if it works for you, doesn't it? That's the thing.
Part of the batter's armoury now, and it's something bowlers have to think about and
100%
sometimes have to set a field for it. Now, is this from the far end?
Is it Dixon?
Is it Dixon?
It could be Dixon back on. I'm not 100% sure because he's too far away from my eyes.
Anyway, 130 for three with two overs to go. Dibabanda is on strike on 49 from 44 balls, so he's stuck at it. He's played some nice shots. He would like to have been able to pick up the rate a little bit, I think, but he's still there. It's important on a pitch where scoring isn't the easiest.
That's a
deliberate edge down to third there. It's a tumbling stop on the boundary. They'll come back for the second, and a direct hit might have had Dibabanda in trouble, but as it is, he completes the second and brings up his 50. From 45 balls. Warm applause from his teammates who appreciate that.
And like you said, stuck at it well.
Yep, good contribution.
See what he can do with the last 10 balls now.
Mm.
11 balls. 12 balls.
Pace off again, isn't it?
Pace off into the pitch. Good way to go, I think. Become even more prevalent into the final later on, I would say.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, especially after both teams have had 20 overs of bowling already.
Yeah. I think might even see more spin options if sides have got them, just with that stickiness now. It's actually quite well suited.
And then the carves that into the offside, that's just going to be a single to deep cover. There's a bit of juggling then. Pings the ball in.
The bowler may have questioned that choice there with the ping in throw with no one backing up.
And no real chance of a run out.
Heard it's one that bowlers always love.
Yeah.
Ball thrown in as hard as you can from the boundary.
Chambers goes across and looks for. Well, I think he was looking for a ramp, but in the end it was too wide and he just sort of had to dance across to it, and it's gone for a leg by on the offside.
One of those ones where when you go for the ramp and you see the pros try and then shovel it over third man, isn't it? Just going for the ramp over fine leg and couldn't quite get the bat round to get it over or anywhere near third man.
Anyway, Dibabanda's back on strike. Picks the slower ball and heaves it into the leg side. But it doesn't beat the fielder on the boundary because they only get one. think having picked that, he would have wanted to get a bit more distance in it.
Pick the longest part of the ground, ultimately. He's probably looking to go a little bit squarer than that.
Now, where's Chambers looking to score here? What's his option? Gone across again and ramped it. He's got it successfully this time, down to very fine leg for four. Nicely played. Had to go so far across, he almost risked flicking it back onto his own stumps there, didn't he?
Yeah. Probably wasn't that far away ultimately, but nicely executed in the end. Got it wide of the keeper.
Yeah, so that boundary makes a decent over for Newton with one to go.
139
for three. With Davis at the end of his run up to bowl the last. Double dander on strike. Again, where's he looking to score? He's probably more orthodox than Chambers, has been looking to dance around the crease, and Remanda just gives it a big heave, and it's not gonna beat the middle fielder. It is, it's beating the fielder. Attempted diving stop, but he ends up only knocking it over the rope for four. That's a good start to the over from De Remanda.
Couple more of those wouldn't go amiss. Go north of 150.
So double banders into 57, the score's 1-4-3 for three. And no ball called as it beats the bat, so it's going to be a free hit. We'll see if the free hit rule still stands.
Be intrigued to see if anything comes of this one.
I think last over with T20 you're basically approaching every ball as a free hit anyway.
Well, so. Yeah, I don't think it'll change the mentality of the batters too much.
Bowled in, but it's a free hit. So they take the pie. The keeper tries to lift the stump out of the ground, but he'd made his ground.
It was a really interesting bit of cricket, that was.
Quick thinking, actually, because instinctively you wouldn't think to run on being bowled, would you?
Very,
you just think,
very sensible play from Mark there.
So it'd be 1-4-5 for three now.
Yeah.
With three to come, Chambers on strike.
Good old bowlers quarrel with the umpire here, discussing whether that was a bye or what happens when. Quite an interesting one, that, isn't
it?
I assume it is a bye. Yeah, I didn't see Jed actually signal it, so I don't know whether that's gone down as a run. That's a good shot, I feel.
That's gone. No, it hasn't beaten the field. Good diving stop at backward point.
Love it, these bowlers, don't they? All about the economy, right?
Every run counts.
Absolutely.
Two balls left in the innings, is it? Lost count with the no ball.
I think it is two. It's three hit counts or something, isn't it?
So yeah.
Should be.
No ball, slow ball again. Good running too as Chambers comes through to face the last ball of the innings.
We think.
Possibly, yeah. I'm pretty confident of this.
Trust your gut, like you said to me before.
Yeah.
I'm feeling overs.
So here's Davis. Over the wicket. Chambers goes down, piss on the pad, going down leg side. They'll come through for a single.
So we have got one more after all of that.
Yep. did not trust my gut. So Dubabanda is back on strike after the leg bye for the last ball of the innings. Surely this must be.
Yes, I don't think this could not be. I'd be very surprised.
Here he comes. That'll just be a single, get good bowling to finish it, finish things off. That's over and that's the end of the innings. So Newton close on
149.
149 for three. So Neston, when they come out, will need 7.5 and over. They'll need 150. I think that's within their range.
I'd say so. I'd make Neston probably slight favourites at this point, based on that. But never know. A few early wickets. Wait and see. But
wickets are key, really, aren't they? They can't just let them bat. They have to.
Yeah, I can't imagine if Neston are in the same position as Newton-le-Willows and three down, for example, that they wouldn't get those runs. So I think they'll need a few more based on the power in that Neston lineup. But as we said previously, 2020 is an interesting game like that, isn't it? You get a couple in the power play and they might fancy themselves there, Newton. So,
yeah.
It's a good game of cricket we've got set up, I think.
Yeah, interesting to see who joins Birkenhead Park in the final. Be back in 10 minutes to find out.
Staying up watching it.
Yeah.
I don't know if you get any who gets the stats on reviewers or online.
Welcome back. The second innings of the second semi is about to start in a few seconds. And Neston will be chasing 150 to join Birkenhead Park and make it an all Wirral final. It's going to be Safi Abdullah with some left arm spin to start the bowling for Newton-le-Willows, who will they'll need early breakthroughs here because they've posted a total which is competitive, but I don't think they'll find it too daunting, especially if they get off to a good start in the power play. Here's Safi. Appeal there, but I'm not sure there was... I think there was bat in it, and the umpire thinks the same as well. I'll tell you who the batters are in just a second. Tight start from Safi. This they'll be relying on their overseas star to get them off to a good start with the ball here, Newton. They can't call on their young Lancashire players Jack Morley and Tom Aspinall because they're away on county duty. Also, all rounder Naomi Dattani is away with Trent Rockets in the 100. Another good line, quite flat trajectory from Safi here. He's not really given the batters time to think about it, time to pick him. That's going to run away. I think that's going to go for four. No, there's an excellent fielding down by the boundary. And a good hard throw as well. David Hurst and Simon Stokes are the openers for Neston. That's a powerful sweep there, and that is going to go to the boundary. There's no one down there in the power play. So a decent start for Neston, who found a couple of scoring shots despite some tight bowling there. I think it's going to be more spin from this end. I think it's going to be Ben Walkden is marking out his run-up. Bowling seam up. Yeah, bowling seam up. My mistake. So it's medium paces. Keeper de Brabando is sort of a few steps back. Walkden's bowling has been excellent. I mean, his batting is his strongest suit, but his bowling has been superb in this year's tournament. He's only gone at 3 and over. Let's see how he does here. Eased away for a single by David Hurst. And it's 8 for no wickets. Nicely played, that's a lovely shot. Really deliberately guided between keeper and the man at sort of fine gully, and it runs away to the boundary. So a good start by Simon Stokes here, a couple of boundaries for him in the first couple of overs. A blast of Michael Jackson's Beat It to greet that boundary. Even though he more sort of guided it than beating it. Walked in ready again. Bowled him! Went for the big shot to the wrong ball and just missed it completely. And lost his bails, and now it's his turn to beat it off the pitch as he's dismissed by Ben Walkden. After a couple of boundaries early on, he's had to go. So that's the early breakthrough that Newton will have wanted. Newton need to make sure they keep the new batters coming to the crease and keep forcing them to start again. So I think if anybody gets set, if they get one good partnership, could take a big chunk out of this target in not much time at all. Here comes Watson again. Good line and length. Again, the bowlers are quickly working out the right way to bowl on this pitch, the right approach to take. Here comes Watson. Driven, but stops, half stop at short cover, and then a bit of dithering between the batters, but they make it for the single. Into the offside for a more comfortable single.
Tommy, great. Chopper's coming in to do an interview now. Gonna have a little chat with you.
Yeah. This is Birkenhead Park captain Steve Hurd, by the way.
Hello, Tom. How are we, mate?
All right, thank you.
Chopper, come in. The mate, man of the hour.
Nice little spot here, Tom.
Yeah. It's nice. Joined in the tent by Alex Harris as well. Well, battered, Alex.
Thank you.
Fucking knock that.
Bit of luck to start with, but...
Yeah. Did you find it? You seem to have found it easier than most to time it on this pitch.
Well, yeah. I mean, when it was up there, a lot easier. It's quite slow and low, so obviously when it's up there, it's easier to get underneath it, really. All the way into the pitch is pretty hard to
it seems
time,
like,
you know, so a lot of your runs really have come straight, haven't they?
Yeah, I've noticed that. All your big hits were sort of straight down the ground, weren't they? You didn't play across the line much.
Yeah. I mean,
so Luke Yates starting a new over for Newton-le-Willows now, 14 for one.
I mean, looks like 150 seems to be a...
The wicket's actually a really good wicket, to be fair. Just keeps a bit low, but actually a really good batting wicket, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
Outfield's quite fast. So, this should be a good game, to be fair. Two very good teams, and you know what I mean.
So, if you win the toss for the final, what are you going
to
do?
A bit unsure, to be honest with you. We've done bits and bobs both this year. We've chased, and we've set totals, and we don't mind doing both, so... Not very good on the tosses this year, so probably end up losing it. But we've got no preference really. We probably have a word of the lads, but it is always nice.
That's a nice shot.
I think it is.
Swept very fine for four.
It's always advantages of both, isn't it? Putting runs on the board and pressure to go and get, because when it gets into them middle overs, it is really hard to, when it gets to 10 and over, and
yeah,
there's only four men in the circle and you can have your sweepers out, it becomes really hard. But if you manage to get someone out and for like 120, you know, it's just run a ball and you can chase plan your chase a bit better. But I think, as we've seen, the two games, wickets have been good. I think it's like 150, 160. I think we could have got a few more runs. To be honest, we had a few too many dot balls towards the end of the innings. We were probably 10, 15 short where we want to be. After way Chopper batted, we could have probably got 170. But say we back ourselves to beat anyone, two good sides, and anyone who we play, we back ourselves to. We do our job, we'll win the game, you know what I mean?
Another four.
Yeah.
Through the offside.
You started well here, Neston.
Yeah. Do you know who the other batter is?
Matthew Strong.
That's
the
Matthew Strong,
the
wicketkeeper.
Dave Hurst, this is Strong.
Dave Hurst with the wristband, okay.
Yeah, it's been a good day. I see plenty of people here.
Yeah, hopefully the sun stays out now as well. Because, good to see more people down for the final. And if it'll be a all Wirral affair.
Could be, yeah. Or not. It's either all Wirral or all comp, isn't it?
One yeah, yeah. Or the top two in Division 1.
Yeah.
It's like
is there any news how Northern are getting on today? Is there any update on that?
Northern made 157.
Oh, good.
But from there, is it down to 17 overs?
Oh, is it?
Or the chase is 17 overs anyway. I don't know what the calculation was, but that's against Longridge. Bit of a miscue there, but it runs away.
Total off 17.
Mm-hmm.
Anyone get runs?
I haven't seen the card, to be honest. I've just been saw the update. So yeah, Neston 25-1 off three overs. See if Watton carries on after a successful start.
Safi only bowled one over.
Safi bowled one over at the start, yeah. Safi bowled the first.
Holding him back.
Chambers coming onto bowl.
A lot of good players, Neston, so it'll be a.
Dom Chambers.
Case of holding wickets in the tank, I think. A lot of good players.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Dom Chambers is coming on after one over. Just one over for Watton, so. Chris Chambers happy to rotate his bowlers and seeing what works. Definitely seems like pace off, doesn't it?
Yeah, we bowled a lot of spin, so we bowled 12 overs of spin, and probably our most economical bowlers. Obviously, Caleb bowls in the power play, so it's a bit different. But
yeah.
Rollo and Louis, they bowled pretty well.
Yeah.
Just because it can keep low too, and when you get that short ball off the spinner, you want to just rock back and try and put and cut and.
Beats short cover and goes for four.
But
good start to the over from Hurst.
Yeah, I think pace off is the way to go.
Seems like in every innings now, somebody's got 50.
Yeah.
It'll just be a case of who can be best sort of staying with that guy and,
mm-hmm.
To get him on strike. I mean, they've upped another. Probably if they'd have rotated the strike a bit better when they'd lost a few wickets,
yeah.
It could have been a different game, really, because
they had two lads who were upset at one stage, didn't they? Who were really going well. And when people are in and hitting well, it's hard, and that's where you need to break through and get some new bat to decrease, and then it becomes hard to come in straight away and get going.
Newton's best partnership was the last one, because
they batted well too.
Found a couple of boundaries
and
as well.
And Ravinder, they batted well, didn't they?
Yeah. That's beating cover as well, is that going to go? Yes.
Yeah.
No one out on the boundary, so it's four. So strong start to the over from Hurst.
Just go on the edge of the end, I think.
It seems like 150, so well, I mean, we got 150. Newton-le-Willows end up 150.
Mm-hmm.
It's sort of par score, I'd say.
High, that's going to bounce short of the rope, but clear it in one bounce. So another four, three fours from the over so far.
Yeah, good start, strong start.
It's hitting them well, isn't it? This
bowl.
Is hasty, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. And just one big partnership could
break the back of the chase, yeah.
Definitely.
It's a great chat, that last one.
Mm-hmm. Chambers again, what's he got? That's better. It's going to be full, it has to be right up there, isn't it?
Yeah. It's tough to bowl on a power play when you've got no sweepers out, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Ball, yeah.
It's the man out, but it's one fine leg. Someone behind the wicket, that's in the air, but comfortably into the gap, it's just going to.
Four.
Roll to the fence. It's another four. So four boundaries off that over from Don Chambers. That's probably the biggest scoring over of the day.
I think you see Safi so on in a minute. Safi's coming back on. Surely.
Safi back on for the rest of the power play with you.
No, I think Safi. Well, I think what's the score now?
41-1.
You need a wicket, don't you? So.
Yeah, they need to start. They need to play this partnership.
I think it'll be long before you see Safi back on.
Yeah, he's wearing number three, he's wearing someone else's shirt, but yeah, there he is.
He needs to break the partnership, got some new lads in.
As far as Neston are concerned, I mean, the way I'd be looking at it is they can afford to just sort of
take a
couple off Safi's overs
yeah.
And target the bowling at the other end.
Yeah.
Bournemouth, bad stuff, so it's a dangerous player, you know what I mean? Not seeing much of the other lad at the strike and that. Heard he's a decent player though, isn't he?
Good young player, yeah. Come through the set of the Neston, yeah.
Yeah, Matt's really good working. Matt's people, strong. So. Not faced many balls.
Hits it well.
Edge that one, but he's going to get four for it. Yep, a genuine edge that, but
yeah.
Four runs, they all count.
Counts, yeah.
Safi's giving him some there.
Really good setup as well, isn't it? You know.
Yeah, they put on a good day, haven't they?
Good day, yeah.
Very good. Like I said, decent number of spectators in.
Yeah.
Sun's out in the final yet to come. It's Safi now. That's nudged into the leg side, no run.
It's gone a bit warmer too, to be fair, it's nice.
Mm-hmm. Sun's back and forcing that into the offside for one.
Be looking to sweep here. Is there two men out?
Well,
I'd like to add the midway for deep square, I think.
Yeah.
It's like one of the stronger shots, though. It's four.
So he's back and cutting. Yep. Lovely shot for four. No one out on the offside, so you can't really,
yeah.
Can't really drop short.
No.
Newton is badly in need of it. Something to happen there.
Yeah, it could be.
As we know, those, you know, one wicket can soon change things.
It's not easy to come in and start, is it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they'll want Hurst, won't they?
Yeah. He must be on 30-40 now.
33, I think, 34. Again, that's found the gap as well. Not totally in control of it, but did enough. That's the key to power play, isn't it? Just
sitting them while they are like.
Yeah.
Great shot through cover. It takes a good player to hit through cover.
They're shuffling the field after every ball because scoring all around the clock, really, isn't it?
Man going out on the offside now, you know.
Yeah.
So he's
going to bring
now
the slog sweep out now.
Yeah.
Let's see. Went for it. Though. It's just worth one. It's the edge.
Okay, I'm walking. Pleasure, Tom, as always, my
mate.
Right,
yeah, thanks for
your time.
Thanks for joining me. Cheers. Interesting approach to guest commentary slots, that. Ben Watkins can have another go from this over. The one successful bowler so far. Let's see if he can make another breakthrough at a time when his side really need it. A dangerous Hurst on strike. Here comes Watkins now. Back of a length and beats him outside off. Good bowling. Oh, straight for four. Magnificent strike. Great comeback after being beaten. It's a clean hit down the ground. Absolutely flew to the boundary. Response goes short and gets pulled for four. This is excellent batting from Hurst. That's really destructive. He's taking this game away from Newton. It's looking bleak for the comp side at the moment. Two fours taking on to 45 off just 20 balls. Walked in again. Clubbed firmly into the leg side, but with no one. Here comes Walton now. Uses his feet. Hurst and drives him through the offside for four. Magnificent stuff. This is just a lesson in power play batting, this. Newton don't really have anywhere to turn at the moment. They can't stop the scoring, let alone take the wickets. So Hurst up to 49. Swing and a miss on that one, though. If Watton can get one on the line of the stumps, then it might pay off for him, but that was another big over for Neston. And more trouble for Newton-le-Willows. At the end of the fifth over, Neston is 67 for one. At the end of the power play, rather, at the end of the sixth over, 67 for one. They need 83 more to win. And the thing is, while Hurst is hitting every other ball to the boundary, Matt Strong can just play himself in at the other end. He's under less pressure, so he can play himself in. So if and when Hurst does get out, he can, he can then accelerate. Here's Luke Yates, the field spread now after the power play. Luke Yates' first over went for a few, but it is a different game when you can have fielders out on the boundary. Here comes round the wicket to the right-handed Strong. Big stride forward and a big shot, which has gone for six. Just clears the dive of the fielder. Down at backward square leg. And everything seems to be going Neston's way at the moment. Here's Yates, a bit shorter, a bit flatter. And carved out into the offside. Will they think about the second? I think if they'd run a bit harder, they could have got two there. But they're happy with just the one. And Yates to Hurst. No run, still on 49. Goes to the sweep, another dot ball. Good comeback from Yates after being clobbered off the first ball of the over. But he's got a hold of that one, he's got all of that. That's gone all the way for 6 over square leg, and that brings up his 50. Excellent 50 in just the 7th over of the game, of the innings. He's bossing the chase for his side at the moment, David Hurst. I don't know if this is deliberate, but they are more than halfway there, as the DJ has decided to play Bon Jovi's Living on a Prayer. So if this was deliberate, then a hat tip to the DJ. If it wasn't, then it's just one of those things, isn't it? So after 7 overs, the score is 80-1. Need another 70 to win. So Newton need to make something happen, and fast. Looks like Safi Abdullah is going to bowl his 3rd over. Change of ends for him. They need a change of fortune to go with it. Sending his fielders, choosing his boundary fielders with care. But to be honest, as well as Hurst in particular has been striking them, he's been taking the fielders out of the equation. Safi. Big attempted sweep from Strong, but it's down the leg side and it's a wide. Bowled him. Bowled him, that's the breakthrough. Strong has to go, played back to one that's probably a bit too full, maybe a bit of turn, lost his off bail. Newton are delighted, they needed that breakthrough, they need a few more as well, but that one in particular. So first wicket for Safi in his 3rd over, the change of ends has worked for him. So a left-hander comes to the crease. Safi making sure all his fielders are in the right place. A long on here for the left-hander. There's men out on the offside boundary too. There's Safi. It's a forward push and no run. This is good stuff. huge shout for LBW, but I think it's going to be outside off stump, surely. He's a long way forward, he's got a big stride in. A big drive and a good stop at short cover, keeps it down to one. It's the right-handed Hurst. He's the one they really want. Hurst happy to just play him out. He's only got one over left after this. I still know he's the most threatening and the most economical bowler. It's dragged down a little bit and punch into the offside, it'll just be one. To end Safi's successful over, 83 for 2 off 8 overs. With Hurst on 56 rather. New over, and it looks like a change of ends for Ben Walkden as he has Hurst in his sights. No one off that, punched into the offside. Luke Camden is the batter at the other end, by the way. Hurst on 56, Camden on just one off three balls. Hurst down the ground, drives through the offside, no fielder's going to catch that. Down there towards the spectators in front of the fence. Another boundary, his 12th four to go with his 1-6, goes into 60. Energetic run up, full pitch ball, heaved over the leg side for another four by David Hurst. This really is a fine innings. And it's a 64 now. And more than two a ball. He's hit 13 fours and a six. So I make that 13 fours, that would be 52, and a 6 makes 58. He's only run 6 runs himself. Everything else has been in boundaries. It's an excellent display of T20 batting. As Neston starts to close in on this target. What's Walkden got? Back of a length. Brilliant improvisation. Brilliant. Down on one knee, flicks it over fine leg, and that goes for another four. finding a way to score off the back of the length balls, which has proved so hard for every other batter today. Watson again, that's carved through the offside, that's beaten the fielder's dive, and that's going to go for another four. Three boundaries from the over. They're looking like finishing this off very quickly, Newton, Neston rather. It's looking grim for Newton-le-Willows, and it's looking like it could well be an all-Wirral final in the Echo Cup. A gust of wind that's making me worry slightly for the integrity of this gazebo. Going to level with you, it's sort of leaning a little bit, but professional that I am, I'm going to carry on commentating. Walked and charges in from the far end, bowls back of a length. Hurst just punches that to mid off and there's no run. That's the end of the over, and Walkden's head's down there. There's not much energy in the field. They sort of they know which way this one's going, I fear, for Newton-le-Willows. After nine overs, it is 99 for two. They need 51 to win from 11 overs, with eight wickets in the hut. Newton need. That is bordering on miracle time, isn't it? Hurst is 72 not out of 34 balls with 15 fours and 1 6. So, new over. Full toss, which Camden punches down to mid on. There's no run. Paddy Connolly, the bowler for Newton. Hurst on strike now. What's he got here? 72 off 34 so far. Taking his time to make sure he knows where all the fielders are. That's tossed up by Connolly, and Hurst just nudges it into the offside for a single.
How are you? You alright?
There's Connolly again, round the wickets to the left-handed Camden, who
great stuff, Luke.
Punches it down the ground for a single. Neston have had such a strong start here, they don't particularly need to take any risks. That's the problem that Newton have got. They don't need the big shots. There's Connolly, balls to Hurst. So makes it into a full toss that he carves out to the cover boundary. And that's another four. He moves on to 76. Connolly again, that's carved over cover, it's a wide one, too full. Carved over cover for another four. Hurst up to 80 now. And score up to 109 for two. There's 41 needed. Hurst down the wicket, but it's forced to just push that defensively into the offside. A small victory for the bowler there, but another big over for Newton-le-Willows, and it's looking big over for Neston, rather it's looking grim for Newton-le-Willows at the moment. They need something extremely special. ...110 for 2 off 10 overs. They needed 7.5 an over, they're going at 11. Chambers from the far end. As they seek breakthrough, which, to be honest, they need a proper clatter of wickets here in Newton if they're going to have any chance of defending this now. Neston need just 40 to win. They've got 8 wickets in hand, and they've got 10 overs to get them in. Chambers hits Camden on the pad. Nothing doing now. Umpire seems to suggest it's going down leg side. Big shot from Camden, over square leg, 2 bounces over the boundary. No let up, this is an onslaught from the Neston batters. This rate they're going to give themselves some time off before the final, which isn't due to start until 4:30. But I doubt this innings is going to go the distance. Stump and clubbed into the leg side by Camden. They can jog a single with the fielders out on the boundary. But just then you can understand it, but the body language of the Newton fielders is quite flat at the moment. There's just a not much going for them out there at the moment, but you never know. Things can change quickly in this game. Hurst back on strike. 91. Goes for one down the leg side and doesn't get a hold of it. That's going to be... Is that going to be called byes? Leg byes. Just a leg bye, just a single. Camden with another. Gives it an almighty swing, doesn't he? Almost baseball style, the way he wields his bat. And when he hits it properly, it stays hit. That one just sort of dribbled down to long on for a single. Chambers again, bowls to Hurst. Bowled him, chopped on. Stayed back, it maybe kept a little bit low. We got a bottom edge onto his stumps and the danger man has gone. Has he done enough damage? You'd have to say he probably has, but his innings, excellent innings of 82, is at an end. Probably a match winning knock, but it's over. The bowling changes have got the wickets, and you never know. If it's going to happen, it would take something like that to start it. So let's see. Warm applause for Hurst as he leaves the field after the fine innings. 82, including 17 fours and 1 6. Scoring all around the pitch, really, 360 degrees. Didn't seem to have a weak spot. The bowlers haven't had anywhere to bowl to him, to be fair. He's the one better today who's been managing to get balls away from back of a length. That was the last ball of the over as well as taking a wicket. The score is 117 for 3. We need another 33 runs to win. Camden pushes Safi's first ball to point for a single. Club captain Dane Williams is the new batter. He's not listed as captain today. Ash Davis is listed as captain, so maybe he takes the T20s, but Dane Williams is Neston's club captain anyway. Here's Safi round the wicket to the right-hander. Fired in, fizzed in at his stumps, and he can only push it to the offside for a single. This is Safi's last over, of course. And they don't need any more than singles at this stage. Coming forward carefully, cautiously, if they can afford to play out this last over from Safi, and then none of the other bowlers have offered anything like the control required. Oh, and Savallon's bowled him, it's kept low and turned in, and that definitely kept low. Skidded off the pitch and went way underneath Camden's attempted pull and clattered into his stumps. So, 2 wickets and 2 overs for Newton. Who knows? Who knows what this could bring? 3 wickets and 3 overs, in fact, isn't it? They needed something like this to happen. And of course, they've got the danger man Hurst, so Camden's gone for 9. In any case, they still make Neston massive favourites. I don't know if at this stage it's possibly opened a door. Newton possibly got away into this game with two new batters at the crease now, and starting isn't easy. The downside for them, of course, is that Safi, who you think is their best bowler, has only got a couple of deliveries left. Forced to bowl him out rather than hold him back. So the new batter is another left-hander. Safi has him in his sights. Bowls full and he can't get it away. Turns that away on the leg side though with the spin. Easy single down to deep square leg. And that's the end of the over and the end of Safi's spell. 120 for 4 is the score. 30 runs needed off the last 8 overs. Stranger things have happened, put it that way. Connolly, having taken the wicket of Hurst in his last over, is going to continue from the far end. Here he comes now, right arm over the wicket to the left hander. Edged down to third for a single. Genuine edge that, I don't think he guided it. He found the edge. Luke Jones is the new batter, by the way, the left-hander. That's the right-handed Williams on strike now. Safi's figures, 4 overs, 2 for 26. Now here comes Chambers, balls to Williams. Short, he goes for the pull. Doesn't really get hold of it, and Walkden can make a sprawling stop there at mid-on. And there's no run. Here comes Chambers again. This one's fuller and punched into the offside, but with the same result, no run. A fizzing throw from cover to the keeper to Bavanda to make sure of it. There's Chambers again, right arm over the wicket. Full again, punch this one, beats mid wicket, and they will get the single. Single gets a musical sting. The DJ must have really liked that single. Generally boundaries and wickets only, but singles pushed along on as well, it seems now. Here comes Chambers. Jones has a go but can't beat the bowler. And our dot balls, that's just ridiculous, come on. Chambers again beats Jones outside off stump. And that's the end of the over. So a good over for Newton now, just one run off it. And maybe, just maybe, you never know. They might have a way back in. 2 runs off it rather, so it's 1-2-2 for 4. After 13 overs. They only need 28 runs, but the pitch is doing a bit, it's up and down. There are 2 newish batters at the crease, neither of whom has managed to really get the ball off the square yet. So you never know. There's going to be some more spin, it's going to be the left armer, Luke Yates. Here comes Yates. Williams is back and cutting out to deep cover for a single. field switches around slightly for the left-hander, left-handed Jones. He's slug sweeping out to deep mid-wicket, and it's just put down on the boundary. It's a tricky running chance, but he just put it down. Managed to stop it going over the rope, but couldn't quite hang on to it. Yates now fires another one in and beats the batter on the outside edge. Things are just starting to happen. You do feel like they need to take their chances, but they are at least creating some. Things are starting to happen. It's been a good over so far from Yates. Could have had Jones. And Williams isn't getting him away either. That one's shorter, hits him on the pad, well forward, I don't think he's going to get that decision. It's from around the wicket, the left armour, so he would have had to have straightened, and I just think with the batter having a big stride, and the umpire would be guessing. But more encouragement for Newton-le-Willows. Here's Yates again. Back and punched out into the cover, that will just be a single. So a good over there from Yates. Not quite a successful one, but they've still keeping the run rate down. Who knows? After 14 overs, it's 1-2-5 for 4. 25 needed from the last 6 overs. So the asking rate has gone up to over a run a ball, which from where they were when Hurst was well set and smacking fours everywhere is quite a difference. It should be within the reach of Neston's middle order, but more good accurate bowling like this, who knows. Chris Chambers being very careful to get all his fielders in the right place as Dom Chambers starts his run up now, past the umpire, right arm over the wicket and back on his stumps. There's another one that kept a little low to Williams, and he can just push it into the offside for a single. Chambers again. Jones is back, and that's a genuine edge. That down to third. Yates comes round and fields and pings it back in very well to the wicketkeeper. Crucial period of the game, this. Neston know that if they bat well, they've got this chase in hand, but here comes Chambers again. Full and beaten, and Vivanda whips the bales off, but Williams was still in his crease. But the atmosphere has just shifted slightly. A few wickets and a few tight overs. It's just changed a little bit. Here's Chambers now. Williams can't beat the bowler. You get the feeling that the batters know that. Do they have the patience to wait for the wide one, to wait for the long hop when it comes and put that one away? Or are they going to be tempted into a shot they shouldn't have played? Here comes Chambers. That's down the leg side. That's going to be called a wide. No? Not called a wide. Must have brushed a pad. with no run anyway. Chambers now pitched up, they'll take the single there. Push the mid on, mid off rather. So a single off the last ball of the over, but another good tight over. And Neston, who were cantering to the finish line a few overs ago, are still getting there, but they're getting there more of a sedate pace. T20 anthem, which has been co-opted by football fans there. Some sweet Caroline as Luke Yates begins another over. Dane Williams on strike, 22 needed from 5. Chipped in the air and just past the bowler. And that's going to be fielded on the long on boundary. They get a single. Half a chance, I don't think he got there. Yates now going over the wicket to the left-handed Jones. A sweep, top-edged, up in the air. Fielder coming in from the boundary, makes the catch. Yates has got his breakthrough, Jones has gone. And there's another wicket. 129 for 5, 21 needed. 5 wickets in the hutch, and 4 overs and 4 balls to get them. Still make Neston favourites. I have to say that to start with. Neston are still in control of this, but they are not in command of it anymore. They're not bossing it like they were just a few short overs ago, and it's amazing how quickly things can change. This is not the sort of wicket where you can just come in and play shots from the start. Batters are finding it very hard to get going, and they keep getting new batters to the crease. If they keep things tight, who knows? A bit of level 42. Encouragement in the field for Luke Yates here as the new batter comes to the crease. Here's Yates now round the wicket to the right-hander, forward and flicking it down to backward square leg for a single. Short mid wicket, there's no run. And a defensive shot there. This is, after going for a few off his first over, this is a good comeback by young Luke Yates. Left arm round the wicket. Left arm is pushing forward. Keeper takes it and stumps him. He's stumped. Batter's not happy with that, but batters are never happy with being out. Luke Yates has got some fine reward for some excellent tight bowling in this over. And out of nowhere, Newton-le-Willows are in with a chance here. Out of absolutely nowhere. They've taken 2 wickets in that over. It's 130 for 6 of 16. Luke Yates has finished with 2 wickets in an over. They needed a collapse and they're getting one, to be honest with you. Neston's still only need 20 from the last four overs. But down to the lower order now. Is it just going to be a case of someone coming out and middling a few and hitting a couple of boundaries? Because that is so tight, that's all it would take. But who knows? So it looks like Walkden's coming back on. He's in conversation with Safi Abdullah about field placings. Pointing out to the leg side. I'll tell you who the batters are in a second. It's been a bit of a procession, to be honest with you. 130 for 6 from 16. Guy Bradshaw and Mike Stewart at the crease. Bradshaw on strike. Here comes Walkden. Thundering in. Bradshaw just pushes it into the offside. No run. From the far end, hurls himself at Bradshaw, who clips it to the leg side, and I'll just get a single down to the deep square leg. Newton got the momentum to carry them over the line. Here comes Walkden. Stewart's back, no run. There are a couple of people from Upton on the commentary today saying this isn't the sort of wicket where you play back. I think most of the uneven bounce has been when the bowling's been from this end, so not the end that Stewart's backing up now, but that was a risky one to stay back to. Here comes Walkden again, back of a length again. Stewart's forward this time, pushes to mid off. Shy at the stumps, could have been a run out, but they come through for the single. So two from this over so far. Two balls to go. Here's Walkden. Oh, there's a fish at it, and then De Pabanda has a go at the stumps. They were thinking of the single. It didn't take it in the end, but De Pabanda's cross with himself. He feels like he should have got that. And it feels like Bradshaw would have been in trouble. Having been beaten outside off stump. And setting off for a single which was never really there. Sent back by Stewart, and the shy at the stumps just missed. But a dot ball. Another dot ball for Newton-le-Willows. Here comes Walkden now, far end. Thundering into the crease. It's short, it's pushed out into the offside. It will just be a single because the field is in front of the fence. A deep cover. And that is the end of Walkden's over. It was 1-3-3 for 6. Neston need 17 to win from 3 overs with 4 wickets left. Just 3 runs from that Ben Walkden over. The last 5 overs have gone 13 for 3 in the last 5 overs, which just gives you some impression. It's about around that time that they started really putting the batters under pressure, as Queen and David Bowie would say. Neston with Patrick Connolly from this end. Also the question, how does Chris Chambers use his bowlers in these last three overs? He's walked in and Yates are both bowled out. Safi's bowled out. Chambers, I think, is bowled out too, so it's going to have to be someone else from the other end for the last over from the far end. Connolly does have two left. Here he comes to Bradshaw. Sweeps. Gets it down to deep back with square leg, but there's a man on the boundary, so it's just a single. Needed. How does Mike Stewart think to get this over within a few shots? Clubs it down the ground, one bounce, and well fielded on the boundary. He used his feet there, and it's a dangerous thing to do because the odd one is scooting past the bat and Verbander's waiting. But certainly made good enough contact with that, but luckily there was a man on the boundary ready to scoot to his left to pick it up. That's just a single, so two from the first two balls of this over so far. 15 needed. 1-3-5 for six. Here comes Connolly. Bradshaw pushes that into the leg side. They'll just jog the single. Needed to win. Here comes Connolly. Balls to Stewart. Comes down the ground and lofts it over the boundary and over the sight screen for six. It's gone a long, long way, and that's the one shot that they needed. So few runs to play with. That one shot has tilted things back in Neston's favour. Huge six. Straight over the bowler's head. It's now 1-4-2 for six. Eight needed. What's Connolly got? Is there going to be another twist? Right arm over the wicket. Stewart plays that from in the crease and he also dribbles out on the offside. They think about the single and decide against it. So a dot ball to follow the six. Do they have to take these wickets now, Neston Newton? They have to just get them out. Let's see, here's Connolly. Also Stewart down the wicket again and pushes it just past the dive of the bowler. They'll take another single and Stewart keeps the strike, because that is the end of Connolly's over. Oh man, I think it was just a bit too. 1-4-3 for six from 18 overs. They need seven to win. I just think Newton's comeback, as stirring as it was, has just come a bit too late. Too few runs to play with after David Hurst's early onslaught. They finally retrieved the ball with which Stewart hit that huge six, one of the biggest of the day. Both in terms of how far it went and in its impact on this run chase, which has turned out to be a lot tighter than anyone suspected it was going to be. think this is James Beat starting over from the far end. Right arm over the wicket. Stewart's down the pitch again. Clips it to Squalo, where they take a single. I think Stewart's definitely got the power to clear the rope. You wonder if they just want to keep him off strike. Six needed to win from 11 balls. Back of a length. In the air and clears the fielder, and that's going to go down towards the boundary. Excellent diving stop on the boundary by Walkden, flicks it back to himself, pings the throw in, and they just come back for a third. So all that effort by Walkden saved one run in the end. It's 3 to Bradshaw. Stewart's back on strike, and just 3 runs needed to win now. That's wide down the leg side. That's going to be called a wide, and they'll jog another one as well. So those 2 extra runs mean the scores are now level with Bradshaw on strike. I still don't know what happens in the event of a tie. I suspect I'm not going to have to find out just yet. Beat. That's a wide, and it's finished with a wide. What an anticlimactic way to finish. Wide down the leg side. In the end, Newton made a fight of it. They made a real fist of it, but in the end it just came too late. The fight back started too late. They didn't have enough runs on the board. They didn't have enough runs to play with after that excellent early onslaught from David Hurst, who was, when he was out for 82, there was a clatter of wickets and a real sort of tightening of the scoring rate, but in the end they ran out of bowlers who could keep control, and they ran out of runs. And Neston have won by 4 wickets. They will join Birkenhead Park in an All Wirral final. So congratulations to them. Thoroughly deserved. They bowled very well, kept things tight for Newton, restricted them to 149, and David Hurst's onslaught did most of the job of the run chase. So, another intriguing semi-final is done. And the final will be Birkenhead Park versus Neston, and that will be in just about half an hour. I'll get to speak to you then.